everybody, meeting everybody. I hope everybody had a very, very happy Thanksgiving. Welcome to my channel. I am your host, Sean Ferrell. God is great all the time. All the time, God is great. And I just want to say thank you to all my subscribers. Thank you. May God bless you all. Thank you for caring so much about mental health. And let's get right into it, shall we? the topic that I was going to originally bring you that was tabled, I'm actually going to bring it to you right now. Okay? And so, for those of you who deal with mental health, deal with depression, anxiety, or whatever, or whatnot, you know, it can strike at any given time. And so, depression isn't just always at 3 a.m. It can strike when you're out shopping. It can strike when on date night. It can strike as soon as you get up. Or it can strike anytime. So depression isn't always at 3 p.m. or it can be at 3 a.m. It can strike as soon as you get at home or whatnot. But sometimes it's when you're surrounded by your friends in the middle of laughing. And I'm part of the Memphis Dallas Cowboys fan club, and so we watch football games together. I've mentioned this multiple times where people would notice when I'm into the game, I'm into the game, but when I'm not into the game, that was surprising to them. That was surprising to them that I was not in the game. So that was surprising to them, and they really took notice of that. They took notice without saying nothing. So, you know, because it was really unusual for them to see me not being as in the game as they were used to me seeing. It can be just before a loved one's birthday, where you suddenly feel so drained you don't have the energy to take a smile. I talked about sensory overload a few days ago, and I mentioned how sensory overload played a gigantic role in my departure from FedEx, and just before a loved one's or friend's birthday party, where you suddenly feel so drained you don't have the energy to fake a smile. I remember I was at my friend's birthday party a few years ago. And I was invited. Didn't really feel like going, but I went. And I was there for probably like a hour, 2 hours. And sensory overload just took hold. Anxiety just took hold. And depression all in one just took hold. And I just wanted to find the quickest way out. So I pretended like I had a phone call. And went outside like I was about to take the phone call. Went outside, hopped in my truck, and got the hell out. And my depression / anxiety / sensory overload was getting worse. The second that I walked out, I felt better. I felt I could breathe again. But, yeah. in this case, it wasn't just depression that struck. It was also sensory overload, anxiety, or whatnot. And so, it can be in the morning when you feel trapped by the day's tasks and you doubt your ability to make it through. I have anxiety every morning, okay? And so it takes me a while to get going. But once I really get going, once I get in the flow of the day, you know, I'm pretty much, okay. But no doubt about it that sometimes you feel trapped. You feel trapped, you feel you just feel trapped. No. You just pretty much feel trapped. And especially for somebody who wakes up at 3:30 every morning. You know, my girlfriend also, she also wakes up with anxiety as well. But I would say she's kind of like me. Where once she gets going, it pretty much subsides. However, with that being said, I do have my moments during the day where I do have high anxiety. I do have more moments. She probably has her more moments too. And, So, that's the topic that I wanted to bring to you. Depression isn't just always at 3 a.m., 6 p.m., 2 a.m. No. It's pretty much unpredictable, and it's pretty much, and it is so invisible. And it's pretty hard to, see. I have a drink here because my mouth has a tendency to get dry when I'm talking for long periods. So I have a drink to keep my mouth so anyway, I was going to bring you a separate video from this, but I just kind of want to merge this topic into the topic that I'm about to get hit into next. But before I get into that, it was brought to my attention on, I believe it was either Tuesday or Wednesday. Can't remember. And, the director of the Memphis Crisis Center, I received a text and a call. They're saying that somebody wanted to do a video. Look at me, see. I'm messing the thing up. Do a video. Okay. He wants to do an interview. Okay. He wants to do an interview on the Memphis Crisis Center. But he also wanted to know if there was a volunteer there who went through his own mental health struggles. And the director just so happened to think of me. And so when I got back to my truck, after working my first job, when I got back to my car, I found a phone call and a text there. And would you be willing to do this? I said, hell yeah. I said, hell yeah. Yeah, I'm doing it. Yeah. Yeah, I do it. And so the ball's going to get rolling on that next week. I'm totally excited for that. And because I have a lot to say. I have a lot to say. A whole lot to say. So, that's happening. And so, I believe it was Tuesday, okay? With my, girlfriend sent him something, and it was a short video, and the video was titled "See You at the Next Stop," and "See You at the Next Stop," I think that meant the battles that you're going through with mental health. You can stop, you can rest, but you can't quit and you can't give up. Just keep on fighting. Keep on fighting. You can rest, but don't quit. See you at the next stop. And it was a video that I really, really liked. It was only like 35 seconds. It was only like 30 to 45 seconds. But it was a video that I really, really liked. And for the first time in a long time, I really felt, first of all, I know people care about me. Family, they're VIPs. Girlfriend, VIP. Girlfriend, she's a VIP. Teammates, VIPs, you know. My issue is I have not always been able to feel it right here. Oh, and since I'm not able to feel it, I feel that people really don't care whether I live or whether I die or not. I mean, some days I still wake up thinking, my girlfriend, my friends, coworkers, they really don't give a F if I'm not, if I'm gone. They really don't give a F. Why would they? Why would they? I don't think it was. Some mornings I wake up, I'm thinking, I'm not that damn important. Sometimes, I saw this. There we go. Screen started to fade, so didn't want the screen to go black. So anyway, sometimes I wake up and lost my train of thought. Man. Okay. Sometimes I still think that I don't matter, okay? But the fact of the matter is that I do, to several people. And for the first time in a long time, I felt that. I felt it. I know people care about me, okay? The issue is I don't feel it. So, for the first time in a long time, it felt really foreign. It felt weird, but it felt good. It's like my girlfriend was saying, I don't want to, well, it's like she was saying, she was saying, I don't want to see you hurting all the time. I don't want to see you depressed all the time. I don't want to see you in your life. And I felt that. I felt it. And it was like, damn. Felt. Now, since I regained my train of thought, sometimes I wake up and still think to myself, I don't deserve shit. I don't deserve nice things. Well, hell, I'm thinking, I don't even deserve to be with my girlfriend. And when I got off work this morning, my first job, I didn't work my second job, no. Got a 4-day weekend. So when I got off of my first job this morning, it was like I got off. I was productive at work, got off, came home. It's like, Now what? I came home and it was just like, I'm lonely. And there was a sense of loneliness that fell upon me that led to depressive feelings that I've been trying to combat for the entire day. And I was able to get some sleep, but when I woke up and took a shower just a few hours ago, my eyes were maraschino cherry red. You probably can't tell looking at me through the camera, but I looked in the mirror and my eyes were maraschino cherry red. No, part of that is, well, part of that, I didn't get much sleep last night, and I had to wake up super early, a little bit earlier in the morning, because it's busy season. But yeah, and so a sense of loneliness fell upon me, a sense of depression fell upon me. Mentally, today, it was freaking hell. Mentally, today, it was freaking hell. And the loneliness was just so intense, just so dark. just laying on my bed, just watching TV, not even changing the channel. Thankfully, when the TV starts to sound loud for me, when the TV starts to sound a little loud for me, I know it's time to get a nap in. And the TV was beginning to sound loud. So I turned it off. And I took a nap. And I woke up. It was a bit of a task to take a shower. Just a little bit. But I got it done. Depression is exhausting. Depression is tiring. It's really tough, man. It's really tough. Some days are just so intensely dark, where you feel trapped. And then you have fleeting thoughts of suicide begin to pop up. Because the storm is just raging inside of you, at least mentally. But I'm still here. It's not easy. Not easy. But I guess y'all can all see that right there. It says warrior. That's what it says. And I think I'll just end it on that note right there. Hope everybody has a wonderful, wonderful, productive weekend. Thank you for watching my channel. My name is Sean Ferrell. Peace out, y'all.